मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन कंटिन्यूशन ऑफ फर्स्ट पीसी बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन केमिस्ट्री, वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक कंपल्सरी फॉर 2 मार्क्स, लॉस ऑफ केमिकल कॉम्बिनेशंस। ओके, क्लियर? वी हैव फाइव लाइक लॉस ऑफ केमिकल कॉम्बिनेशंस। वन इज लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास, नेक्स्ट लॉ ऑफ डेफिनेट प्रपोर्शंस, नेक्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मल्टीपल प्रपोर्शंस, नेक्स्ट गैलोजैक्स लॉ ऑफ गैसेस, नेक्स्ट फिफ्थ वन अवोगाड्रोस लॉ। ओके, हियर वी हैव द फाइव लॉस ऑफ केमिकल कॉम्बिनेशंस। व्हाट आर दोस लॉस ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास? कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास एक्सप्लेन बाय लेवोइजर, यस्टरडे वी डिस्कस्ड। अगेन विल कंटिन्यूशन टू डिस्कस ऑल दोस टॉपिक्स। फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ मास, व्हाट इज द लॉ, व्हाट इज द स्टेटमेंट फॉर द लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन मास? मास ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल नाइदर क्रिएटेड नॉर डिस्ट्रॉयड, दैट मीन्स ड्यूरिंग द केमिकल रिएक्शन, ड्यूरिंग द केमिकल रिएक्शन द मास ऑफ रिएक्टेंट्स एंड मास ऑफ प्रोडक्ट्स, व्हाट आर द रिएक्टेंट्स आर ऑलवेज कन्वर्टेड टू, दैट मीन्स आर मीन्स रिएक्टेंट्स ए प्लस बी रिएक्ट्स विद, ओके, ए प्लस बी रिएक्ट्स विद ईच अदर एंड फॉर्म द The mass of AB and the mass of C always it should be same. That only it states that, okay, that only okay gives by the law of conservation of mass. Here I am taking one example. Hydrogen reacts with half mole oxygen, and forms water. Okay, atomic mass of hydrogen here 2, atomic mass of oxygen is 16, okay, total 18. The molecular mass, the atomic mass, sum of atomic masses is 18. Here, what about the atomic molecular mass of the water H2? 2 plus 16, 18. See, the mass of reactants and mass of product always should be 6. Okay, here one more reaction. You take combustion of calcium carbonate. This is recalled as limestone. When you heat limestone, what happens here? It liberates carbon dioxide. Okay, calcium oxide and carbon dioxide was formed. The atomic mass of, okay, the molecular mass of calcium carbonate is 100. Here also 100. Total 40 plus 16, 56. Okay, here 44. 56 plus 44, 100. That means mass of, okay, reactants and mass of products will be, always it should be same. This is called, okay, law of conservation of mass. Okay, one more is there, same related. The energy of a molecule neither created nor destroyed. We can't create, we can't destroy the energy of any molecule. Okay, always we are moving. Human beings or animals are all moving one place to another. Okay, we can't create that energy. We can't also destroy that particular energy. That is called law of conservation of energy. Same related to like this, okay. And in continuation, we'll see the one more law of definite proportions. Law of definite proportions. Okay, that means when elements are combined with each other, form the molecules. Any element combined with each other, same element or different element, and form the compound. That compound should have the definite proportion, should have the fixed ratio, That only we call as law of definite proportions. Suppose, for example, hydrogen is there. It reacts with oxygen. What happens here? We'll get 2H2O. Here we'll get the water. What is the ratio of here water, hydrogen to yeast and and every time when oxygen and hydrogen combine with each other, okay, this fixed ratio, the formed compound has this fixed ratio. This may be indicated like this, 2:1, 2:16 or 1:8. This we call as law of definite proportions. We have a fixed ratio. Here molecules which combine, atoms which combine with each other and form the molecule, those should be have a fixed ratio of atoms in the molecule. We call as law of definite proportions. You take any one, suppose hydrogen reacts with oxygen. Okay, what happened here? Forms H2O2. H2 here 2, here 30. That means 1:16. During the formation of hydrogen peroxide, this H2O2 we call as hydrogen peroxide. Okay, during the formation of hydrogen peroxide, here, okay, hydrogen and oxygen should maintain the one fixed ratio. One definite ratio. Fixed means definite. Definite ratio, that is 1:16. That we call as law of definite proportions. Law of definite proportions. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the one more law of multiple proportions. Law of multiple proportions. Law of multiple proportion means, for example, sulfur is there, reacts with oxygen and forms sulfur dioxide. Same, sulfur reacts with oxygen and forms sulfur dioxide. Here, oxygen only reacts with same element. Both are same elements. But here, 1:1 ratio. Here, okay, we should take this one is 3 moles, this one is 2 moles, 2:3 ratio. 2:3 ratio. Here, the ratio of sulfur and oxygen 32:32. Here, the ratio of sulfur is 32:48. Okay, 32 means 1:1 ratio. Here, 32 means 16, 2's are, and here 2:3 ratio. And here we get 2 molecules. See here, same molecules involves in different proportions. And form the different compounds. This we call as law of multiple proportion. Okay, the atoms which combine with each other and form the compounds involving different proportions or multiple proportions and form different compound. This we call as law of multiple proportion. This we call as law of definite proportion. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the one more Gay-Lussac's law. What is Gay-Lussac's law? Gay-Lussac's law for gases. Okay, it explains about the volume of the gases before reacting, after reacting. Okay, it explains about the here. Gallium dioxide alpha gases. Okay, here I am taking first example. After that, I will do statement. Hydrogen reacts with chlorine. One gallium of hydrogen. Okay, one gallium of chlorine reacts with each other and forms two moles of hydrochloric acid. Two gallions of hydrochloric acid. Two gallions of hydrochloric acid. The sum of volume of the reactants always is equal to the volume of the product. Volume of the product. That states by Gay-Lussac's law. That explained by Gay-Lussac's law for gases. Okay, here volume of gases is 1 plus 1, 2 values. And here finally we got 2 values. Okay, during the formation of hydrochloric acid, okay, always it should be involving this ratio. 1:1:2. Yes, now. 1 ratio of hydrogen, 1 ratio of chlorine forms 2 ratio of hydrochloric acid. During the formation of hydrochloric acid, okay, it should maintain this ratio. This we call as Gay-Lussac's law. Okay, here I am taking one more reaction. Okay, here nitrogen reacts with hydrogen. Nitrogen reacts with hydrogen, forms ammonia. One gallium of nitrogen, 3 gallions of hydrogen forms 4 gallions of ammonia. 4 values of ammonia. Okay, here this is the 4, here also 4. That means, okay, during the formation of ammonia, what is the fixed ratio? 1:3:4. This is the fixed ratio. This is reactant, this ratio belongs to reactant, this belongs to product. Okay, always the sum of volumes of reactants is equal to the volume of the product. This given by Gay-Lussac's law. This is given by the Gay-Lussac's law. This is recorded as Gay-Lussac's law. Okay, in competition, we will see the one more Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law. What is Avogadro's law? Okay, what is Avogadro's law? Avogadro's law. Okay, here at constant temperature and pressure, at constant temperature pressure, the volume of the gas directly proportional to the volume of the gas indicated with V, directly proportional to the number of molecules. Okay, for example, 1 liter hydrogen gas, okay, contains same molecules. 1 liter oxygen also contains same molecules. 1 liter ammonia also contain same molecules. By increasing the volume, number of molecules should be increased. The number of molecules indicated with N. This is the relation. What is the Avogadro's law? The volume of the gas directly proportional to the number of molecules present in it. Number of molecules present in it at constant temperature and pressure. Okay, this is called as Avogadro's law. And here, just I will give, in next class I will explain that concept, mole concept, 1 mole, what is the 1 mole. Okay, I will give. Here, what is the Avogadro's number? What is the Avogadro's number? One mole of molecule contains 6.022 × 10⁴ molecules. 10⁴ molecules. Okay, one mole of gas at STP standard temperature pressure. Standard temperature pressure, 1 atmosphere pressure and 25 degree centigrade temperature. We call standard temperature pressure. One mole of gas occupies 22.4 liters. One mole of gas occupies 22.4 liters of value. These are the two important statements. One mole of hydrogen contains 6.022 × 10⁴ molecules. One mole of oxygen also contains 6.022 × 10⁴ molecules. That means, when you are purchasing the banana, we ask you, we never ask, give 1 kg banana. We ask 1 dozen banana. 1 dozen always is equal to the 12. Suppose if we ask 1 dozen apples, that is also equal to the 12. 1 dozen any material, any food material or any. 1 dozen glasses, 1 dozen computer, 1 dozen books, 1 dozen pens. Always is equal to the 12. Here also same. 1 mole is nothing but how many molecules? 6.022 × 10⁴ molecules. 1 mole of gas occupies always 22.4 liters of value at standard temperature and pressure. Standard temperature and pressure. This is recalled as Avogadro number. This is recalled as Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law. These all are the laws of chemical combination. How many laws of chemical combinations are there? Five. What are those? One is law of conservation in mass. Law of conservation mass. Second one, law of definite proportions. Law of multiple proportions. And Dirac's law. And finally, Avogadro's law. Next, in continuation, after the laws of chemical combination, Dalton's atomic theory. This is an important question for 3 marks. Every time in PV exam, it will come. Dalton's atomic theory. First given by the, explained by the John Dalton, based on the just simple one thing, simple particle that we call as atom. Atom is Latin word. In Latin language we call atomio. Atomio or atom means indivisible particle, undivisible particle. Discrete particle, smallest particle. These are simple words of atomio. Indivisible particle is simply called as an atom. John Dalton tried to explain properties of that atom and chemical properties of that atom, physical properties of that atom. By explaining some assumptions, that theory, that assumption, those assumptions are visibly included in Dalton's atomic theory. See, main points in Dalton's atomic theory, important points, postulates, these are all same. Sometimes they ask postulates, important points, main points. What is the discussion? Just describe Dalton atomic theory means same. Discuss Dalton atomic theory means same. Explain postulates of Dalton atomic theory means same. explain main points or important points of determinant atomic theory means same. Okay, here first point, first we try to explain about the matter. Already we know about the matter, which occupies the space and which has mass, we call as matter made by the small particle, small discrete or indivisible particle called as atoms. The matter made up of by the combining of indivisible particles or discrete particles or smallest particles, okay, are called atoms. This is the first statement. Then second one, atom gives an element. Atom gives same type of element, not give the different type of element. Chlorine atom gives chlorine element only. Chlorine atom not give the oxygen element. And after the formation of elements, element and atoms are having same mass, same structure, same shape. Chlorine atom, chlorine element, both are having same properties, same mass, same shape, same structure. That is the second statement. Okay, here atoms gives different elements. Okay, those are having different mass. Hydrogen atom gives hydrogen element. Oxygen atom gives oxygen element. Different atoms give different elements. These are having different mass. Hydrogen mass is 1. Oxygen atomic mass 16. Okay, and these are different. Shape of hydrogen, shape of oxygen different. Structure of oxygen, structure of hydrogen different. Okay, all are the different. Okay, same atom gives same elements. Different atom gives different elements. Different elements. This is the third statement in Dalton's atomic theory. Okay, here same atoms are different atoms. Same atom, hydrogen reacts with each other, forms hydrogen molecule. Same atoms reacts with, interact with each other and forms homo molecules. Different atoms also reacts with each other and form hetero molecules. That means atoms. Okay, same atoms reacts with each other, involves in different chemical reactions. Okay, combustion reaction, addition reaction, substitution reaction, or any reaction forms homo molecules. If different atoms involves in reaction, forms compounds are called hetero molecules. And here, during the formation of compounds, the mass and energy of that particular molecule neither created nor destroyed. How can I say? HH reacts with each other, forms H2. The atomic mass of hydrogen is 1. Okay, molecular mass of hydrogen is 2. Molecular mass of hydrogen is here 2. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. Here also. Okay, atoms. The mass of atoms neither created nor destroyed. Energy also. For example, during the involved of energy. Hydrogen requires 100 kilocalories. This hydrogen requires 100 kilocalories. It contains 200 kilocalories of energy. 200 kilocalories of energy. These are the important statements in Dalton's atomic theory. What are those? First statement is matter made by individual particles or discrete particles, smallest particles are called atoms. Okay, that means first who discovered the atoms? Dalton atomic theory. Okay, if they ask one question, who discovered an atom?
Dalton.
Okay, John Dalton. Okay, here atoms use same atom use same element, different atom use different element. Same atom use same element, having same structure, same okay, same shape, same mass. Different atom use different elements and gives different elements having different shape, different structure, and all the different properties. Okay, here all the same atoms react with each other and form the homomolecule. Different atoms react with each other and form the heteromolecule. During the formation of compounds, there is no destruction of energy, mass. There is no creating of mass and energy. Okay, these are the important points, main points in Dalton's atomic theory. And here, what are the disadvantages of Dalton's atomic theory? Disadvantages of Dalton's atomic theory. What are the disadvantages? Okay, here this Dalton's atomic theory not explains about the loss of chemical combination. Okay, not properly explains about the loss of chemical combination. How chemical combinations are observed? Why here Avogadro's law, the volume of the gas is equal to the number of molecules. Why? Okay, it failed to explain the type of statement. Okay, during the preparation of compound, during the synthesis of compound, energy or mass cannot be created, cannot be destroyed. Why? What is the reason for that? Okay, it also explains, cannot explain, does not explain, or fail to explain Gay-Lussac's law. What is the Gay-Lussac's law? The sum of volumes of gases always is equal to the product. Volume of the product. Why? Why always is equal to the product of volume of the product? Volume of the reactants. Okay, it fails to explain Gay-Lussac's law. And here, here molecules form. How the molecules are formed? Hydrogen reacts with hydrogen and form hydrogen molecule. How hydrogen reacts with another hydrogen atom? How will get the hydrogen molecule? Hydrogen molecule. Okay, here hydrogen reacts with oxygen. Hydrogen is gas, oxygen is gas, but water is liquid. Okay, it fails to explain mechanism of formation of the homomolecules and heteromolecules. He gave statement. What did he give statement? Okay, hydrogen reacts with hydrogen, forms hydrogen molecule. How formation of the hydrogen molecule from the hydrogen atom? He fails to explain this concept. These are the disadvantages of Dalton's atomic theory. This is about the loss of chemical combination by Dalton's atomic theory. In continuation, we'll see the significant figure. What is the meaning of significant figure? Okay, stoichiometric equations are there. Stoichiometric chemical equation. What is the meaning of stoichiometric chemical equation? We'll see in continuation. Okay, today I want to ask one question. Who is father of chemistry? Father of chemistry, Indian father of chemistry, mother of chemistry, okay, father of physical chemistry, father of inorganic chemistry, father of organic chemistry. Okay, you think about these questions. Who is father of chemistry? And here Indian father of chemistry, mother of chemistry, and here father of physical chemistry, father of inorganic chemistry, and father of organic chemistry. Okay, you search all this, otherwise tomorrow I will attend. Okay, one more is there. What is the meaning of PEN is equal to RTC? Is the one principle. It is a one principle. Okay, this is about the discovery of proton, electron, neutron. P means proton, E means electron, N means neutron. Proton discovered by Rutherford. Proton discovered by Rutherford. Electron discovered by J.J. Thomson. Okay, here neutron discovered by James Chadwick. PN is equal to P means proton, E means electron, N means neutron. Okay, here R means Rutherford, T means Thomson Chadwick. Proton discovered by Rutherford, electron discovered by J.J. Thomson, neutron discovered by James Chadwick. Okay, yes, this is the principle for the discovery of particles which are present in atoms. Okay, in continuation, we will discuss different topics. Thank you.